multiplications of pair of linear equations in two variables in simpler words, word problems. Okay, now first some problems I am taking, only those problems I will give you. The problem number, exercise number is given on the top, note down in your notebook and clearly you understand the question and its answer here, and you may practice again. Already how to draw graph of a linear equation was discussed at length, so here I'll go a bit faster. Now check this, 5 pencils 7 pens together cost 50 rupees, whereas 7 pencils and 5 pens together cost 46 rupees. Find the cost of one pencil and that of one pen. That's the question. In solution, let the cost of one pencil be x and cost of one pen be y. In that case we will have two equations here for the two conditions given. Condition 1, cost of 5 pencils plus 7 pens is 50. That is the first sentence you can see, first part of the sentence. Therefore we can say x is the cost of one pencil, so 5 pencils cost is 5x, 7 pens cost is 7y. 5x plus 7y equal to 50 is the equation 1. Then condition 2, cost of 7 pencils plus 5 pens is equal to 46. Therefore 7 multiplied by x plus 5 multiplied by y equal to 46. Now we have to solve these equations graphically. That is the question. Of course I did not write that. So for drawing the graph we need to take the solutions for each of these equations. Now we turned the word problem into two mathematical equations, a pair of linear equations in two variables. Now for each of these equations we have to find two solutions minimum. For the first one, if I say y equal to 0, you get the value of x there very easily, and but x value cannot be equated to 0 and immediately you cannot get the value of y in integers. Therefore think of it, and this is the solution table. Actually all that you how to take the solutions you had already a practice, so think of the solutions and how to do the answer, how to check the answer only we I'm revising here. So let the value of x be 3, then 5 into 3 15. If I take 15 this side, 50 minus 15 35, 7y equal to 35, that means y equal to 5. Now you got this 3 5 as one of the solutions. Then if I take y value as 0, then this is completely 0, 5x equal to 50, so x equal to 10. So 10 0 is another value, another solution for this particular equation. For the second equation, now I'll take differently the values, not zeros. Of course I cannot check zeros here. I'll take x value 8, then it is 56. When I take 56 to the other side, it will be 46 minus 56, that is minus 10. 5y equal to minus 10, y equal to minus 2. This is the first solution. If I take x value 3, then it is 3 into 7, 21. 21 when taken to the right side, 46 minus 21, 25. So 5y equal to 25, therefore y equal to 5. And if you plot these points on a graph sheet together, these two lines will be meeting like this, and you get one point here, 3, 5, that is nothing but the solution of the equations, of the pair of equations given. So what is the solution here? 3, 5. That you can easily estimate also, you can guess also, because 3, 5 is one of the solutions for this also. Therefore 3, 5 is the solution of this particular this particular pair of equations. Now let's go ahead with another question. From now onwards I will be little slower. You see, this is the question from exercise 3.3, question number 3, third one, first one. In third main there are many questions given. Page number also I want to, if you want I will tell you, page number for this is
53.
Yeah, 53. Yeah, 53 page. You be in this page only. 53. I'm going to give you two problems, and 54 page two problems. So where question is a very simple question is given. The difference between two numbers is 26 and one number is 3 times the other, find them. For the given conditions, you have to make two mathematical equations which are nothing but a pair of linear equations. Let the first number be x and the other number be y, such that this second number y is greater than the first number x. I am just letting like that. Then the equation, the question you read again, the difference between numbers is 26, keep it aside. One number is 3 times the other. Here y is the bigger number, y is the bigger number, x is the smaller number. Therefore y, I take the first number, is 3 times, so y equal to 3 times of the small number x, 3x, that is my first equation, y equal to 3x. Next, the difference between the bigger number and smaller number I take, then it will be positive, difference will be positive. So y minus x equal to 26, or y minus x equal to 26 is the second equation, equation number 2. Now see, y is expressed in terms of x in the first equation. We need not do any transposing, etc. Directly we get the value of y there, that we substitute in equation 2. Let us substitute the value of y from equation 1 in equation 2. Then we have, in place of this y, I write 3x. 3x minus x is equal to 26. Then what? 2x equal to 26, because 3x minus x is 2x, that is 26, and x equal to 26 divided by 2, that is 13. Now once you got the value of x, you will easily find the value of y, because y equal to 3 times of x, 3 times of 13, that is 39. Now the solution is, the numbers are 39 and 13. Now what is the difference? 39 and 13, 26. 39 minus 13 is 26, and 39 is 3 times 13, is it not? So the conditions are satisfied when we checked or verified with the answer. So this is the problem, entire problem children, question and here, and answer is given here clearly. So you can take a screenshot or note down immediately. I will wait for you for 15 to 20 seconds. Charita, did you understand this one? Charita? Kiran Kumar? Mansa? Kiran Kumar is...
Understand, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good, very good. Right. So, shall I... tell me. Somebody is asking a question. Who is that? Tell me. Yeah, somebody started asking a question and stopped. Okay, no problem. Harshita, following now? BLS Harshita, you are following. Right? Shall we go ahead with the other question now?
Yes, sir.
No. Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now,
question. Yes, sir.
This is,
yes, sir.
Okay. This is question, yes, number 2 from the same exercise, from the same page. This is second question from the third one. The larger of two supplementary angles exceeds the smaller by 18 degrees. Find them. One sentence question. One sentence. Question is given in one sentence. Two conditions are given in one sentence there. You see? Very simple question. Now for understanding the question and doing it, you should know what are supplementary angles. Venkatesh, V. Madhu, can you tell me what are supplementary angles? V. Madhu or Mahesh, Gurbharat, no one is speaking, that means they kept the phone aside and went off. Nice. Yashneel, no? Yashneel is not speaking? Right. T. Varshita, okay. If you don't know, at least you say don't know, so that I understand that you are in the class. Right. Now I tell you, supplementary angles are a pair of angles whose sum is 180 degrees. So, if the sum of two angles is 180 degrees, then we call the angles a pair of supplementary angles. That means here, if I say angle, one of the angles is x, another angle is y, then x and y together is 180 degrees. That means x plus y is 180 degrees. And the larger angle, say
sir,
y, yeah, tell me. Venkatesh, tell me, go
sir,
ahead.
Sir, my got stuck soon.
Huh? It's okay.
Sir, the sum of two angles together forms 180, that is called a supplementary angle, sir.
Very good, very good. It's okay. Now come to the class now. So, if I say x is the larger angle, y is the smaller angle, then larger exceeds smaller by 18, meaning if you subtract the smaller angle from the larger angle, you will get 18. Or x equal to y plus 18. In both the ways you can write the equation. Now for the conditions, we'll write the equation. Let the larger angle be x, smaller angle be y. We know that the sum of measures of angles of supplementary pair is 180 degrees. So according to the given information, what is next? X plus y equal to 180 degrees. Then x minus y, that is smaller, bigger minus smaller, equal to 18 degrees. And now you can do these in any way you like. Now I am doing it in the substitution method again. So x equal to 180 minus y I take from the first equation. Now this value of x I will substitute in the second one for obtaining the value of y. So substituting this value in equation 2, we get 180 minus y equal to 18. Where from this 180 minus y has come? Because x equal to 180 minus y, I am putting in the second equation, in place of x, I am putting 180 degrees minus y. Already minus y is there, is equal to 18. So 180 minus 2y equal to 18. This 2y I will bring this side, 18 I will bring this side. Then 180 minus 18, you can take 18 away from 180, you will get 162. That is equal to 2y, or y equal to 81 degrees. You got the value of y quickly. Now, when y value is 81 degrees, x value is 180 minus 81, that is 99. Therefore, the angles are 99 degrees and 81 degrees. Very simple question and important also. It may come for a 2 marks question or a 3 marks question in the final exam. So, note very quickly. I am letting you to note down the question for a while. After that, I will talk to you. Jyotish, are you following? Jyotish, Purna Kamlesh?
Yes, sir.
Purna Kamlesh?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So, note down quickly. Now, shall we move on to the third question here? That is fourth one from the page number 54. From page number 54, the same question is being continued. Third one, fourth one. And we popularly call it a taxi problem. And one more such question is there in the other exercise also. That also we will do simultaneously. We can do that also. But before that, let me complete this exercise. The taxi question now. Now, shall I move on to the next question now? Shall I put it on?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
That's nice.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is the question, children. The taxi charges in a city consist of a fixed charge together with the charge for the distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, the charge paid is 105, and for a journey of 15 km, the charge paid is 155. What are the fixed charges and charge per kilometer? How much does a person have to pay for travelling a distance of 25 km? Now, here we go. Let us take charge fixed charge as x rupees and distance covered. For every kilometer distance covered, the charge is y rupees. then this fixed charge everybody should pay. So x plus the distance covered into y rupees. So for a distance of 10 kilometers, it will be, see, let us let the fixed charge be x and the charge per kilometer be y. Then let the charge per 10 kilometers will be x plus 10y, because y is the charge per 1 kilometer, x is the fixed charge. Everybody should pay this one. If you travel only 10 kilometers, 10 into y plus x. If you travel 15 kilometers, that is 15y plus this x. So together you have to pay. So these are the equations for the question given here. Charge per 10 kilometers is x plus 10y is 105, and charge per 15 kilometers is x plus 15y equal to 155. Now equation 2, I am subtracting from equation 1 directly. Now that means I am using elimination method. Already the coefficients of x are the same, 1 1, in both the equations. Therefore I use elimination method and I am writing one equation below the other. First I wrote the equation 2 and I wrote the equation 1. Next I am subtracting one from the other, then x and x will get cancelled. 15y minus 10y equal to 5y, and that is equal to 155 minus 105, that is 50. So y value is 50 divided by 5, it is nothing but 10. Therefore this value I will put back in equation 1. So x plus 10 multiplied by 10 is equal to 105, because value of y is 10. I put here 10 multiplied by 10. So x plus 100 equal to 105. So x equal to 105 minus 100, that is 5. So we obtained the values here already. So the fixed charge is equal to 5 and charge per kilometer is 10. Now you have to find the charge per 25 kilometers. So you all find the charge per 25 kilometers also after noting down quickly.
Rupees, sir.
Very good, Gagan. That's a nice answer. 255 is the right answer. I am also putting that here. I did not type it out. I'll type it out. So charge per 25 distance of traveling. First they have to pay the fixed charge, and for every kilometer y rupees they have to pay. Therefore that is equal to x is 5 plus 10 into 5, that is x is 5 plus 25 into 10. I will write 25 into 10, that is better. 25 multiplied by 10, that is equal to 255. That is the answer. So I will put this on the screen again. All of you note down this problem, because this is an important one. Now we are left with just 6 minutes time, children. So we will continue with the other one. I will quickly explain on a screen, not step by step. I will quickly explain the next problem. Fraction becomes 9 by 11, etc. I will do that and then we will stop the class. Okay. I am going to close this and open board problems again. Children, I am going to send this PDF to you. Send this PDF also to you. So you may write these questions. See, this is what I prepared for you to send to you. I am sending this PDF in 3 pages. Write whatever I discussed in the PowerPoint here. Now you can see the problem, next one, that is 5th problem here. A fraction becomes 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and the denominator. If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 by 6. Find the fraction. That is the question here. Could you all see the question? That is in different color. Now, we will see solve this one. Let the fraction be x by y. X is the numerator, y is the denominator. According to the given information, if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator, that means x plus 2 by y plus 2 is equal to 9 by 11. Now, this you have to simplify further. That means 11 into x, 11x, 11 into 2, 22, equal to 9 into y, 9y, plus 2 into 9, 18. Cross multiplication here, children. So, bring this 9y to the left side, 22 to the other side. 11x minus 9y equal to 18 minus 22 is minus 4. Next, we have, if 3 is added to both, the fraction becomes 5 by 6. So, what I am doing, I am going to add 3 to the numerator and denominator. X plus 3 by y plus 3 equal to 5 by 6. Again, cross multiply, 6 into x, 6x, 6 into 3, 18. 5 into y, 5y, 5 into 3, 15. So, 6x minus 5y equal to this 15, 18 I will bring this side, 15 minus 18 is minus 3. Now, in equation 1, 11y minus 9, 11x minus 9y equal to minus 4, 6x minus 5y equal to minus 3. Now, from equation 1 we obtain, from the equation 1, minus x equal to minus 4 plus 9y by 11. This is for substitution method, children. Now, we obtained equation 3. So, as many numbers as you want, you can give, but use them properly. Now, put the value of 3 here, substitute this value in equation 2 here. That means, 6 multiplied by minus 4 plus 9y by 11 minus 5y equal to minus 3. That is, here, if you multiply by 11 completely, 11, by 11 I multiply the entire equation, then what will happen? This 11 will be cancelled. When you multiply this 5 by 11, it will become 55. And 3 by 11, it will become 33, minus 33 here. So, 6 into minus 4, minus 24, 6 into 9, 54y, minus 55y equal to minus 33. So, here, when you simplify the y terms, you will get minus y. And bring this 24 the other side, it will be plus 24, minus 33 plus 24 will give you minus 9. Minus y equal to minus 9 or y equal to 9. When once you got the value of 9, you substitute back in the equation 3 here. So, minus 4 plus, that is y, 9y is there, 9 into 9, 81 by 11. So, it is 77 by 11, it is 7. So, the fraction is 7 by 9. So, understand this one clearly and note down. Of course, I am going to send this PDF to you. I will reduce the screen size here and put the entire problem on the screen. So, those who want, you can note down quickly or take a screenshot immediately. This is the entire problem. Right? I think still I have to reduce a bit. Right, this is the entire problem, answer.